Welcome back to the channel, guys, where you join us for a hybrid fitting with Sam Smith at Golf Repairs For You. I've got the Ping G425, and it's a bit of a self-fix, Sam, so I've ordered the shaft off eBay.
Yeah.
You know, I got a stiff shaft, 80 gram, but it weren't custom fitted, it was just sort of, you know, I know a lot of guys at home will do this as well, is that I bought a shaft that I thought would, you know, fit me as a golfer.
Yeah.
And we've just measured its swing weight, haven't we? And by fluke.
It is literally fluke, yeah.
It actually measures D7, which I've been measured for in irons and driver.
Yeah.
But we're going to build this, or you're going to help build it, me a club that, for teeing off with, because I don't like fairway woods.
Yeah.
And when we've done testing it in the past, we've found that the hybrid is the most consistent club, you know, that I've got, apart from driver off the tee.
Yeah. Yeah, so, like I said, we'll see if we can get it, mate. Like a strong kind of forward, you know, we can maybe set it up to. Like I said, just gives you another option, doesn't
it? Yeah.
Again, you know, if we can get set it up, just be quite a high launch, low spin thing. Like I said, it'd be great for distance. And again, if you're only using it off a tee mainly, then it's fine to be set up like that.
Definitely. I mean, it's 19 at the minute. Obviously, we could maybe make it a bit lower, I guess.
Yeah, we could go to 17 and a half. And you think same as your driver, you know, go lower loft, opens the face, help with that kind of ball flight. So straight away, I'd want to be kind of going lower loft than you normally use.
Yeah.
But like I said, as a starting point, we'll kind of hit shots based off what you had it set up at.
Yeah.
And then, like I said, we'll go from there, basically.
Right. Guys, this could be a great video for anybody that struggles with fairway woods. I know a lot of people do.
Yeah.
You know, you might even be struggling with driver and looking for that club off the tee like me. I mean, it's not so important for me now I've got driver, but I still like to have that option on sort of shorter par fours.
Yeah, of course.
You know, rather than just hitting a four
iron. Yeah, you need an option. Like I said, it's you're going driving like a four iron, it's such a big gap, so you definitely need something to bridge it. And like I said, there's a few ways you can do it. So hybrid, you know, strong hybrid is definitely one of them. So yeah, we'll... Do you find that definitely goes a bit more left than your kind of driver?
Oh,
now?
Definitely.
Now you kind of
got it.
Yeah,
definitely. Okay. Driver's my most sort of fade bias club, I would say now. You know, one that.
Which makes sense because it's the only one we've kind of fitted so far.
I mean, that felt a good swing.
Definitely turning a bit.
Yeah, I'd say when I'm out on the course with this, it's one I'll, you know, you guys might do it at home. You set up down right off. With my driver, I'm setting up down left off.
Yeah, and again, it's hard to be trusted at every time, you know, picking a different starting line. It's hard to trust
if it. I try and aim that left off with this, I'm lucky if it stays straight and fades. You know, I'd usually turn it left.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's difficult. I want to aim down left.
And
swing it like a driver, but I just can't trust it.
Yeah.
Like that one, and that's what I've just done there. I've just aimed that a little bit left, tried to get that feeling of fade.
Yeah. And again, that's what you're kind of doing, similar to your driver when your original driver.
When we first started.
Yeah, and that was everything, was just kind of straight left, couldn't get the face kind of open up enough to get that ball flight. Yeah, so again, it's doing similar things. Go a couple more for me, Gary.
I mean, I'm going to be honest, I'm not in the position to buy a new club today.
Yeah.
I've obviously come down with intention of getting a shaft, Sam, to find you. But if it is the case that you have to look to a new head, then we can do the fitting. Obviously, I might have to just buy it next month.
Yeah, that's fine. Like I said, it's...
But let's see what we can get out of this, if we can get all...
Yeah, no, like I said, I always try and do it with yours to begin with anyway. But yeah, for me, it's just, you've not had one finish right side of the grid.
That felt a really good shot, that.
Yeah, and like I said, it's just, everything's just shutting down. Very similar to, like I said, what you did with your old driver before. You know, similar kind of things. And I think, it's getting that feeling that, you know, you can aim down the left and you know it's going to come back. Like I said, with this at the minute, you've definitely got to aim right for it to be drawing.
Yeah.
Which again, it's hard to just trust when you've got two different clubs doing two completely different ball flights.
Yeah, I'd like to try and have the confidence to turn left with this and
block
the left side out if I can.
Yeah, 100%.
That's the idea.
So I think that's enough. Let's have a look at the data.
Right then, Sam, you break my heart.
Yeah, you can see it's very left. That's the main thing. I'd say strike-wise, everything seemed okay, so I wouldn't feel like we'd need to, you know, take any out.
Yeah.
I'd say it's just dispersion, really. You can see there, you know, it's that one to the right, which is the best one, really. Everything else is way too far left. You know, completely wrong ball flight that you're trying to create. And if we look at, you know, compare.
Is there anything you can do for me?
I can have a look. I think it's going to be a similar thing to, in terms of, like, your driver fit, where if you get it, you know, open face. Obviously, the only annoying thing is, at the minute, if that's already D7 as a fluke.
Yeah.
If that had been, say, D2 as standard, it would have been way easier to kind of go heavier swing way and get that sensation. But because it's already kind of there, you're a bit more limited. And then what we'll do in a fitting, we'll use the CPX jumbo grip anyway. That might help a bit, being a bit thicker. But then again, you look at the data, launch and spins, you know, pretty good to be fair. Bit of fluctuation again, because if some really turn over, you know, the spin could really drop. And I think the one that went straight definitely spun up a lot more. So again, trying to get that consistency. Again, launch varies a little bit, kind of 2.2. So like if you look at like individual shots, yeah, range from like 9.9 to 16.5.
That's insane.
It's a big variance. So like it started off quite high, then it dropped a lot. But again, that's for one that went right, and you can see spin just shoot up.
Yeah.
So you need to be kind of creating them spins, but not hit it left at the same time. Which is obviously be a bit of a challenge, because obviously generally anything that fades spins more. Whilst we drive, we set up that it was fading and spinning low, which was a good combination. But like I said, we'll see what we can do. So I've got a few things, I think, to kind of help, you know, get that face a bit square. Like, so if we look at club data now, just the exact same, great path. And very consistent. But you can just see it's a shut face.
Yeah.
So your path's completely neutral, but you're just coming in 4.6 shot. So it's just straight pull. Straight kind of pull, hooky, draw. Striking's pretty decent. A lot out of the middle. Again, hitting down. Not too much of an issue with a hybrid. Again, good club head speed. So again, you'd be kind of verging on stiff and X, but I want to be looking at stiff because you want that kind of feel. But yeah, for me, it's just exact same as driver, trying to get our face closer to neutral.
Right.
And then, like I said, it just get a lot straighter flight. So, see what we can do. So, I'm just going to be putting a CPX jumbo on this one. So, first one I'm going to try, Gary, is a Ventus Blue 8 Stiff. So, they don't do a red in the hybrid shaft, so your nearest option would be the blue. Again, similar weight to your kind of KBS. But like I said, hopefully, you know, being, again, higher end, it's a Velocor option, not a stock option. So for me, it makes sense to kind of start with that because it matches your driver. So, yeah, we'll have a look, mate.
We've just got the heater on in background, guys. Just warm it room up a little bit.
Get a bit cool.
Turn it off in a minute.
But yeah, so I've just measured your shaft as well, and it's playing half an inch longer than standard, so it's kind of playing like two hybrid length, which ain't a bad thing in a way if you want it for kind of distance, but we've got to bear in mind that, you know, some shafts might be slightly different lengths with, you know, obviously trying to cater for all hybrid lengths, so we need to just, again, just weight it accordingly if we need to. But yeah, let's see how this Ventus goes.
A few people have asked in comments, and I've not been able to reply to them all because I'm not 100% sure an answer, but I've been fitted for D7 in driver.
Yeah.
Would that stay pretty consistent throughout the other clubs in my bag?
Yeah, pretty close. You'd never really kind of go D2 or something.
Yeah.
It could be a very different kind of feeling. I think I've messaged a few where, you know, sometimes, especially like maybe wedges, sometimes people go heavier with wedges because you get that kind of pendulum feeling, a bit more help with tempo.
Yeah.
But yeah, like I said, I'd never really stray too far from whatever swing weight's your preference.
Yeah.
Say your driver's like few D7, you know, you'd always be around that D7 within probably one, maybe two either way. But again, you know, anything now, let's say D2, I think you can just feel it straight away. It just doesn't feel right. So yeah, never really try and stray from that. Like I said, we'll try and keep it D7 best we can. Like I said, you know, with the weight kits as well. Obviously, again, big things are going to be the grip because we've gone to the jumbo.
Yeah.
Going to really drop the swing weight.
What about loft?
Yeah, so what I'm doing first, I've gone straight lower.
Right.
So I've gone to 17.5. And again, it's going to get our face open. Same as your driver. you know, lower loft, get a bit more kind of penetrating flight, lower spin,
yeah,
help with distance, but main thing is just face angle. If we can get the face a bit open, you know, coming into impact, that'd be great. Yes, a minute before I change any weights. Bloody hell. This is a problem. Yeah, so C7. So
we
dropped 10. The only issue we've got now...
Have you got enough weight?
I don't think I have. We can go lead tape, but again, shaft length, if you look now, this is shorter than yours.
Yeah.
So that's making a big difference.
Yeah.
And again, we can build it longer, so we can work it out, but to physically try D7 a minute, we might have to go... A bit of lead tape, maybe.
What's the heaviest? What weight's in there?
Heaviest, I think it's 10. I think my stock's 10. The heaviest I've got is 18. So again, that's only adding about 4 points. So it's mainly because of the grip as well.
Yeah.
But again, we know you like that grip, so we need to kind of stay with that.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'll admit some shafts we're going to struggle to get the swing weight. With your drive, it was way easier because you've got two weight ports, yeah, so you can add mast in both ports.
So you're telling me like maybe a PXUE might have three swing weight points will be easier.
Dead easy. There's no issue in terms of getting the swing weight right. That's why I like PXG. It's so easy to get weighting correct. Again, so like I said, if we do it just for argument's sake, we'll put an 18 in.
Yeah.
But like I said, it's just not going to feel heavy enough.
Is it like whatever shaft you try and put in here now, are you going to struggle? Or is it just that particular shaft?
No, yeah, some might be longer.
Yeah.
How I've kind of done it is generally... stiff flex I build for kind of 3 hybrid length, that's quite common, and like regular flex for like 4 hybrid, but because obviously yours is already half inch longer playing like a 2 hybrid shaft,
yeah,
I've got a few but not many because like I said, it's not a common club having like a 2 hybrid length.
No, I get what you're saying.
So yeah, like I said, you know, no issue if you ordered one, we can build it longer, but I think even if we went to say the same length as that,
yeah,
I still think you'd maybe struggle
to get up to
get it up to it. But like I said, we'll put a heavy one in, see what you think. And then we can always try PXG, and like I said, that's got absolutely no issue. 100% can get to D7,
right,
and get it like fade bias at the same time.
Okay.
So like I said, it's a bit more versatile. Right.
How do you know where everything is?
Oh, it's in my head. It's just, I don't know. It's hard to explain. Like this one's got Callaway, Cobra, Ping. The other one's got TaylorMade, Titleist.
Well, they're all hybrid ones.
They're all just every wood and hybrid.
Right.
So, like with Ping, it's the same for fairway and hybrid.
Right.
Okay. So, they're kind of universal. And like I said, I just need to look for the 18. I'm pretty sure that's the heaviest one.
If, obviously, it's not going to get to D7, how much what would the weight be, do you think, to get it to D7?
Like I said, I think in a minute this will get it close to D2.
Oh, it's nowhere near it.
Yeah, like I said, we'll do it now to see, but it's nowhere near it. And like I said, every half inch you go longer can add 3 points.
Yeah.
So if we go half inch longer, we can get close to D7.
Yeah.
But again, the only issue is, again, with where the weight is, we're having to put all the weight to the back, which gets a spin up.
Sam, if it's only going to get to D2, we're gonna have to just get fit for PXG.
Potentially.
I've tried quite a few heads, guys, and I've not really settled on anything so far. So I'm probably just going to have to go with Sam's advice, I think.
Yeah, it's just an awkward one. Like I said, I know we've not even tried anything yet, but like I said, a lot of it's down to the grip because you prefer this grip, which is fine, but we just need to work around it. But like I said, some heads are just limited where you just can't get the, you know, the swing weight high enough. Where's the bloody screws? But like I said, we'll put it in just to see. And if you want to hit a couple, it's fine. But I think straight away, you'll just feel that it's too light.
Yeah.
But, you know, we've done a few changes in terms of going thicker grip to help delay release. You know, lower loft to open the face. So we've done quite a bit to it. But again, swing weight's a big factor in terms of being too light. It might just do the opposite in terms of a release. So, yeah, straight away, yeah, just under D2. So, like I said, it's all right, but it's nowhere near. Kind of. If it was like D5, I could maybe work with it, but It's up to you, mate. If you want to try it, we can do.
So I just hit 2-3 balls.
Hit a few. Because, again, we need to see what the shaft feels like. Because this shaft can be D7 in PXG, so we can make work.
Let me try it.
Let's try it.
Oh, that felt nice, that shaft.
It's definitely not bad. But that's where you think that D7 would be even more chance of keeping it in play.
Yeah.
Because it just slow you down a bit. But in fairness, that was one of your better ones with your current setup.
It's not as aggressive, is it?
No, it's still obviously more left than I want to see, but nowhere near as bad as yours. Yeah. And I thought it'd be better, but it's still not where I want it to be.
I just hit one more, but I mean, it does show you how much you can just change by just changing the grip.
Just go thicker grip, open face with a loft, and all of a sudden it's a bit straighter. So we'll see.
Well, I suppose you have increased the swing weight a little bit as well, haven't you?
Well, no, because we've dropped it, haven't we? So we've added weight in the head, but the swing weight's dropped to 5 points.
That was just a one that I think I've left.
That's not bad, really. But again, it's definitely nowhere near as left, so it's better.
Yeah.
But it's still not, I think, where I'd want it to be.
Yeah.
And that's where, sadly, sometimes I've had people come in for a fitting, and you do need a change of club if you want to get it fully optimised.
Question is then, if I ordered, let's just say, PXG, would that shaft be any cheaper because I'm ordering the club or not?
No, because I think if you did it through PXG directly with that shaft, it's more upcharge than if I did it separately.
Right, okay.
But again, your price point, because it's a high-end shaft, and then obviously maybe a new head, obviously again, it goes a bit pricey, like your driver in a way, sadly, but it all depends on how optimised you want to get your equipment.
Yeah.
If you want it the best it can be. Shot. So let's look at the data on there. I mean, it's definitely straighter.
Yeah.
But it's still a little bit hit and miss in terms of kind of a ball. So, you know, a bit better ball speed, more consistent.
Yeah.
Bit lower launch because obviously we've knocked the loft down. Spins higher, but makes sense to me because we've had to add a lot of weight at the back.
Yeah.
But that's great. Look at starting line. Go from 1.8 left to 1.9 right. And again, bit of yardage, 4 yards carry, 5 yards further.
Yeah.
But again, with your setup, that's going to be, I know you can try with shafts, but that'd be one about the best you could maybe do with it in terms of your head. And then a different head, I think, would be even better.
Just stressing on, like, I know I'm stressing on this for a bit here, but how much lead tape would you have to add on to that to get to D7?
Every 2 grams is 1 point, so 10 grams.
And how would that sort of like be applied?
Yeah, that's the only issue, because especially with high, because you hit down on it could just come off dead easy. So you'd have to do what's called hot melting, which I don't do, unfortunately, where you get glue in the head.
Right.
But for me, you just have to get it kind of all that side, get it fade biased.
Yeah.
But again, look at face angle now. So your path's changed.
Yeah.
So you've now got a bit more out to win, but your face now is 0.6 open. So already we've changed your face angle by over 5 degrees, which is massive. Mm. Club head speed's a mile an hour quicker, more efficient. Yeah. But, yeah, for me, again, try all the shafts, but that's about roughly the best you could do.
Yeah.
And like I said, I think a different head would be even better. Similar to your kind of driver scenario where, you know, different head you could just see made even more of an impact. But of course that's down to you
if you're wondering why I'm looking a bit blank, guys, obviously cogs are going round and I'm thinking how much I really want to be spending.
That's the thing, because it can add up very quick.
Can we do one more thing?
Yeah.
Can we try my shaft that I broke? Mate, honestly, I'm on a budget.
Yeah.
And even the guys at home might come down and just think, well, I can't afford to do this.
Yeah, I get it.
Could we make the most of my current shaft, the KBS, set it lower, thicker grip?
Yeah, we can have a look.
Is that a possibility?
We can see.
I'm just thinking the whole idea is I want to take a club away and play with it rather than thinking I've got the information now but then need £400 to buy an hybrid.
Yeah.
It's not going to happen.
No, I completely get it. Like I said, obviously, we've done different shaft, but we've gone lower loft, thicker grip. So I think that's helped a lot in terms of a face angle.
Yeah.
Probably more so than the shaft.
I'm just thinking, as much as I'd love to go into a new club at PXG and get the money, I just can't afford to do it.
Yeah.
So I've got to find the way of making that as good as I can.
Yeah. No, that's fair. Like I said, it's a common thing where, and I get it, if people come in for a shaft and end up all of a sudden needing to buy something to get more performance,
yeah,
not everyone can do that. So again, yeah, I've had it where we have to really work around it and see what we can do.
Yeah.
I think I'd have to do is maybe cut your grip off.
It's fine. You can cut whatever
so
you want.
We can put the CPX on.
Yeah.
But yeah, we can do that and just see what it's doing in terms of performance.
If we can. I mean, obviously, if we go through that and then it didn't even outperform the Ventus,
yeah,
it may be that I just have to come back with some money in my pocket.
Yeah.
But let's see what we can actually do with my club.
Yeah, like I said, we've all current setup. Like I said, it is a case of knocking the loft down, going through your grip, then just get it reweighted, because again, that will drop a bit. But that's with your 10 grand weighting, so I don't think that would be an issue in terms of getting it back to D7.
Yeah.
And like I said, hopefully then it would perform a bit better, but it's hard to say how much better, basically.
Let's do it.
Okay, that's fine.
Right, so it's the moment of truth. We've got the loft down.
Yeah, so we've gone down to 17.5. We've gone to the CPX Jumbo. And like I said, it's still got the 18 grand weight from when we just tried it in the Ventus, so I'm going to see what it's balancing up at and if we need to change it.
I'd imagine it's going to be higher, possibly.
I'm hoping so. Yeah, it is, which is good. So we can take some weight out. Not much.
What do you think? How much are you going to take out?
It will be... the odds of this. My mate needed a fitting yesterday. I've ordered a weight, and he's took the weight which you need. He's took the 16 gram. So Warren, if you're watching, like, it's your fault. So I've got the 40, I think I've got a 14. So all I have to do, I'll have to replicate it and go literally 2 grams of lead tape.
Yeah.
Put it in the same place.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think we'd need the 16 gram, but I think he's took it. I'll double check.
Thanks, Warren.
Thanks, Warren. Warren does watch the channel as well. Because he was saying his club didn't feel, it felt too light, so I reweighted it from yesterday.
It's always your mates, isn't it, that cause you bother. Sometimes you just could have too many mates.
Well, I just said, so take it away, I'll order a new one. And then the odds of you needing the exact weight is quite slim.
It happens every time. It happens for me up at work.
So I've got...
You do favours for your mates, it always bites you in the arse, doesn't it?
Yeah, so I've got a 14, yeah, it's took me 16.
So
we bought some lead tape on. Like I said, it's just replicating what the 16 grand weight would have done. Like I said, it's in the same place, so it shouldn't really affect anything. I mean, you can see now. Yeah, D7.
It's bouncing
out. So spot on.
Yeah.
So like I said, you know, we've gone same swing weight, thicker grip, lower loft, similar to what we've done to the Ventus. But again, because it's a heavier swing weight, hopefully be a bit more consistent.
Let's see what it does. So,
yeah, like I said, it's... I'll be very surprised if it's not as good.
Yeah.
But it just depends if it's going to be 100% optimum. But yeah, we'll see what we can do. There you go.
I didn't actually hit that very well, if I'm telling the truth.
Not done that bad, really.
Is it done all right?
Yeah, a bit. Maybe a fraction short, but it kind of got the ball flight you needed.
That felt a nice shot.
Yeah, so turn it.
That felt nice.
That was good. That's got miles. That's the biggest hit, I'd say. Yeah, great shot.
I think in terms of as far as we can go today, just through basically budget-wise, I'm going to have to make the most of this club, but it'd be interesting to see, like, data-wise.
Yeah, just by, you know...
Just to compare the data.
Yeah, like I said, you know, we've still done a bit. We've gone thicker grip, which is your preference now at CPX, and then, you know, going lower loft to help with the face angle.
That felt great.
Yeah, that's a good shot. That's a ball flight you're needing.
I mean, it is better.
Getting old. Yeah, again, definitely not as left.
Yeah.
You've had one big left, but even that wasn't as severe.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
They're better, aren't they?
Definitely better. So all we're doing is just trying to slow down your release.
Yeah.
And we're still, again, you were limited because your swing rate was already D7 as a fluke, but we've still been able to do it by opening the face with a loft and going thicker grip. So we're still doing quite a few things to help. And again, getting good numbers at the same time.
I certainly stand over it. Don't fear going left as much. You know, I'm feeling as I'm aiming straighter here as well. Which.
And again, the main thing is we've just not got a fade weight we can do, like the driving. Yeah. Here. You know, as soon as we did a fade weight.
I'll tell you what we could do, though, is this weight here you've applied, could it be applied more to, or do you think that's not a permanent sort of fix?
You can try it. So again, you could maybe stay with that 14 gram and put a little bit in the toe.
Yeah.
But it's just making sure that it won't fall off.
It won't just fall
basically.
Off.
Basically. Which, that's the only issue with lead tape when you put it on woods. It could easily just come off randomly.
That felt great.
Yeah, some good shots.
I'd be happy with that. I mean, they're not destructive.
It's going miles for fair. It's going further.
They're not destructive.
260.
Because when I'm hitting this club and I'm landing into an area that's like 250 yards, my vision's not so wide anyway. It's not like a driver where I were really scared.
Yeah.
Even this, when it's turning left, it's in play.
Yeah.
It might be semi. So it's not like, I mean, if I can just bring that in.
Yeah, let's have a...
Should we have a look?
Have a look.
So yeah, first one was just a really bad contact with club. I just hit it terribly.
I might take it out then, because I think everything else has generally been good striking. Because I think you'll probably see ball speed drop a bit. So if we do, I'll take it out. Yeah, I'll take that out.
It was just a bad shot, guys. You know, it were, you know, you just feel like you've just completely glanced the club. You're not even like connected solid. But all the rest were like solid strikes, even if they did go a little bit left.
Look at that. Again, we've still optimised it loads. You've gained 12 yards total, 13 yards carry.
Yeah.
But again, how you've kind of achieved it's really good. So again, 3 mile an hour ball speed, potentially because we've had to add more mass into the head, that's helped with that. You know, launch angle, very similar, a bit more consistent. Spins dropped a little bit, which again, going to help we kind of get a bit more out of it. If that's your kind of off the tee club.
Yeah.
Starting line's not as right. Say Ventus, but it's still moved, what, 2.6 degrees.
Yeah.
But for me, you know, good dispersion, bit left, but a lot more manageable.
Yeah.
But getting a 13 yards carry, 12 yards total, it's still a really good gain.
I'm happy with that gain. You know, obviously, the main thing is it's way better than the first one.
Yeah.
Isn't it? Can you show that other data section?
You can see there.
Yeah, if you go back there, you can see, like, there's four. That my, this club, not set up right, weren't it? This was that shaft.
That was that shaft. And all we've done was change the loft. Re-rate of head because we changed the grip. And then obviously thicker grip. Can that zoom in? That's really zoomed in. But yeah, like I said, it's, you know, we've took out them major three ones. Yeah. That one's pretty similar to that, but a lot further.
Yeah.
And then obviously them two shots that were pretty straight were, again, a lot shorter distance. But yeah, for me, just completely kind of different ball flight. Again, you go on kind of club data. So again, it's not as open as say the Ventus shaft.
Yeah.
Path's a bit in between, but we've still moved it 3.6 degrees just by, you know, lowering the loft, thicker grip, actually swinging it quicker, whether that's maybe confidence, feeling that.
It always is. You've seen that throughout the videos, haven't you guys? The more confident I am with a club. I mean, it's 1 miles per hour.
Well, two based off the original.
Oh, sorry, two based off the original.
But again, a little bit more efficient, that's helping. We have really good efficiency for a hybrid, that is. And again, connections, very similar to yours. So you're getting the same connection, but I think how, because it's maybe a bit more neutral face, that's just helping kind of get a bit more ball speed out of it. Again, you know, swinging a bit quicker is helping with that. But, you know, a lot of numbers stay similar because it's the same shaft. But like I said, face angle, you can see it's noticeably changed.
Yeah.
You know, 3.6 degrees. So like I said, it's a similar thing where I think it's definitely helped a lot. Again, go back to kind of ball data. You know, I like that kind of number in terms of launch and spin. All I'd want to see is a little bit more to the right, which a new head would have done because it's more fade biased, say like in a PXG. But again, for how much extra you'd have to pay, you know, for the sake of maybe 10 yards dispersion shifting to the right, it's a lot of money.
I would love to do it. I just can't. It's as simple as that, unfortunately.
But like I said, for the sake of, you know, the weights are around 15 to 20 pounds. You know, grips probably 10 to 15 normally for a CPX. So again, price point's way cheaper than a new shaft.
I think what it demonstrates, Sam, is that, you know, you can fine-tune someone's already current equipment.
Yeah.
You know, and to be fair, like, if we'd have not even tried that Ventus shaft, and I'd have been more than happy with, you know, that improvement in my current club.
Yeah.
If you've got somebody, it might be you guys at home that can't afford new clubs, but you want the best out of your current club.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at, like, you know, the Ventus, yeah, it's a little bit straighter, but it still wasn't as optimised numbers. Yeah, ball speed was a bit slower, launch was a bit lower and a bit more spinny, which isn't a great combination.
Yeah.
And obviously 7 yards shorter total.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was straighter, but you need to be getting the same distance. And again, you know, that club's for kind of off the tee, and we've set it up in a way now that, you know, it's definitely going to bridge the gap more. So,
no, I do appreciate that, and I'm looking forward to getting out on course and seeing what, you know, real gains it makes. And it already feels, it looks nicer to look down at because it sits a bit more open.
Yeah.
Thicker grip, feels more comfortable. It already feels like a new, better club to me, so
now
I'm buzzing with that. But when I do get some money, it'll be my first club I come back to have another fitting on.
Like I said,
get a new club.
Yeah, we know we can get it even better, but it's definitely improved a huge amount.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's not just, you know, the dispersion we've improved, it's all the other numbers that, you know, that go into getting it more optimised.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's done well, to be fair.
Guys, hope you're enjoying the video. I know it went a bit sort of, went a bit more off pot, because I thought to myself during fitting, go all out, get PHG, you know, and have it fully, but I can't afford to do it. And there's no point in coming down here, Sam, to just be told what I need, but can't afford to actually. I wanted to come down here and get my club better performing.
Yeah.
And I feel like I've done that now. So it's mission, you know, obviously completed.
Yeah.
And then when I am in a position to actually buy a new club, I think I will come down, get the fitting and take the club.
Yeah, I'd say you're about 90% there. Yeah. It's literally, you know, even dispersion was good. I think for me, it's just literally face angle.
Yeah.
You know, get it more open. And then, you know, be really kind of optimised. And like I said, with a driver, it was a lot easier because you've got, you know, the weight in the toe. So it's dead easy to get that face open. Where, like I said, with that hybrid, you're just limited.
Yeah.
So it just depends on brand.
Guys, I hope you're enjoying the videos. I think you can probably appreciate there how much Sam's actually just helped tweak my own club through just a few changes.
Yeah.
And I think if you've got any fitting queries, or, you know, you're interested in new clubs, definitely come and see Sam. He's the only guy I'm going to see for new clubs now, so I'll put his details in the comments, and yeah, hope you enjoy the videos, and we'll hopefully see in a few days' time. Bye.